guys, in this video, we'll be taking a look at the definition of a derivative. So, remember the formula we were given to find the instantaneous rate of change of a function? It was velocity, the limit, as t goes to zero, of delta x over delta y. We also learned that this can be rewritten as the limit as x goes to a of f of x minus f of a all over x minus a. And to simplify even further, this can be rewritten as the limit as h goes to 0 of f of a plus h minus f of a all over h. You should at this point already be familiar with this limit. This limit will come up all the time. This limit is what is called a derivative. Here is the official definition of the derivative. Where x is equal to a, as in our instantaneous rate of change equation that we saw. Now, let's find some derivatives using the definition. Now, typically when they want you to use the definition of a derivative to find a derivative, the question will be worded like this. Find the derivative of the function using the definition of a derivative. To help you follow your own work, it can help to start off by just writing out the definition of a derivative. So, now, we just need to plug in f of x into our definition wherever we see an f of x. But this x plus h right here lets us know that wherever there's an x in the function f of x, I need to replace it with x plus h. I'll show you what I mean. So we can see here in the first part of our definition that it's telling us to plug in an x plus h everywhere there's an x in the function. So our 3x squared here is going to get changed to 3x plus h squared, and our negative 21x is going to get changed to negative 21x plus h, and 48 is going to stay the same because there's no x variable in the front. Now, it's telling us to subtract our original f of x function from our f of x plus h. So we subtract our 3x squared minus 21x plus 48 from our f of x plus h function all over h. Now, we can multiply all of this out, then cancel our like terms. So we can see that our 48s are going to cancel, our 3x squareds are going to cancel, and our 21x's will cancel. So this is going to give us our everything that's left, which is 'cause we have an h in every one of our terms here, we can pull out an h. So now that our h's have canceled out, we're left with 'And so now we just need to evaluate our limit. So we do this by plugging in 0 everywhere we see an h. So the derivative of our function is f prime of x equals 6x minus 21. So, this is simple enough. We just plug in all our numbers into the definition and do some algebra. Let's take a look at another example. So, we're going to find the derivative of this function using the definition of a derivative. Let's write out our definition here. Now, we plug in. So, we know that to get rid of this h, we're going to multiply times the reciprocal. And when adding or subtracting fractions here, we need to have the same denominator. So to get that, we're going to multiply the top and the bottom times whatever's over in this denominator. So that's going to be p plus h times p plus 1, and then we're going to do the same thing in the denominator. And we're going to do that same thing over here. So doing that is going to give us this. Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll perform all the operations in our numerator and try and get some terms to cancel. All right, so now we can combine all of our like terms, which will then cause a lot of our terms to cancel out here. So we can see here that our h's are going to cancel out. So we can cancel that out. So now we're left with So now we can evaluate the limit by plugging in 0 for wherever we see an h in our equation. So once we plug in our 0, our h is just going to drop out. So that's going to leave us with 2 p plus 1s on the bottom. So therefore, our derivative is It will be super valuable to you to memorize the definition of the derivative as you continue practicing. I hope this video was helpful to you. To check out more of our videos, click on the subscribe button below. See you next time.